Science is the intellectual and practical activity encompassing the systematic study of structure and behavior of the physical and natural world through observation and experiment. It only studies the physical world that could be perceived by our senses, and it can't describe things which are not related to the physical world, like the existence of the Creator, the existence of soul, ethics, morals, and etc. But the knowledge that we get from science leads us to the reality beyond this physical existence. Science consists of facts and theories, and this is where the problem arises, because theories are not always true. Some of them are proven to be wrong, and some of them are even lies which were intentionally propagated to the public. And on the other side, the majority of people blindly follow and believe anything that are being fed to them. Because today blind obedience is the norm. So what is the cause that people are taking this slavery system as trustable? It has two reasons. First, the compulsory state-run education system, also known as public school system. And second, the media. With the help of these two brainwashing mediums, they control and manipulate all of the information that you get. Not for a short period, rather for a prolonged period of time. Imagine you enter to the public education system from your childhood till your adulthood, and you constantly get some information as trustable facts. And then you get the very same information again and again from some documentaries and movies that are constantly trying to convince you that there is no reason behind all of the existence. They don't teach you things which help you to know the purpose of your life or things that help you to know your Creator. For instance, they don't teach you the importance of Fibonacci sequence, which is a clear evidence for the existence of a designer. Because they know that if you constantly get such kind of information, your brain is strongly capable of analyzing the information and coming up with the conclusion that there's a designer for all of these things. And that's why they never teach you these things in school. Maybe just a little bit in university, but even there, they don't explain the reason behind it. And that's why we see these actors known as scientists appearing on the screen and fill up your mind with their atheistic explanations and theories. They aren't as intelligent as most of you might think. They are being promoted by the system as credible scientists so that people accept their words.
I mean, we have to remember that much of the roots of biology, physiology, medicine, chemistry, physics, mathematics, and so on, grew up from the Islamic religion. The Islamic religion encourages intelligence and investigation and for us to know our physical world and so on. So the early Muslims experienced this explosion in knowledge that led to the first universities, like the University at Cordoba and so on, and the centers of Islamic knowledge became known as the centers not only of Islamic religion, but also science and learning. And it was from these origins that so much of science has grown.
Of course, not every information they give you is wrong. The majority of information that you get from science agencies are true. But the most focused issues are not those which are true. Rather, the most discussed issues are the false theories. First, they deliver false information and back them up with some irrelevant reasons in order to convince you to accept it as truth. And we see a lot of theories that were supposed to be correct in the past, but today all of them are rejected. Now imagine how many generations have believed them as truth. Second, they deliver the true information and keep the reason behind it hidden. Instead, they give you some false explanation like coincidence to be the reason behind everything existing around us. And that's how they promote atheism among the society.
I'll give you an example. One of my sons was studying biology, and his biology teacher started talking about where everything's created from. In other words, he went from biology to cosmology. Instead of sticking with biology, which is the science of living things, he moved to the science of being, which is ontology, cosmology. This is a whole other branch. But philosophers like Dawkins is a biologist. But very often scientists, because they recognize how insignificant their knowledge truly is in relation to the big questions of existence, they often have this impulse or urge to engage in metaphysics and philosophy, even though they're not trained in these subjects. But they're clever people, they read books, and so they begin to espouse positions about the world, where it came from. Biology is very different. So this is important to note that a lot of their cosmological conclusions are simply false. For instance, they don't believe in a creator God, most of these cosmologists. They say that if the Big Bang occurred, then there's probably alternate universes. So it's just a universe begetting another universe. That's a pure conjecture. And then they have magical formulas that they put on the board. You know, they write all those magical formulas. You see pictures of Einstein, and it's all magic, gibberish. You know gibberish? You know gibberish, where that comes from? It comes from Jabir bin Hayyan. Because when Jabir's books reached Europe, they couldn't understand them, so they called it gibberish. You know, that's true etymology. So they put up all these things, and of course you don't understand. There's only 15 people on the planet that can understand them, right? But he's saying, oh, here, this can happen in quantum physics. Things can just pop into existence.
They know how to manipulate the reality you live. Think of your brain. The whole reality that you're experiencing is being perceived with your brain. It is responsible to perceive, process, and analyze the data that you get from your surrounding. And then with the help of the pre-knowledge that you have, your brain either rejects the data or it will accept it as truth. Now think about it. What happens if someone feeds your brain from your childhood till now with some fake information or false theories again and again? Your brain gets used to it and accepts it as truth. And it wouldn't be able to think otherwise. And this is what system is doing with you. That means that a part of the reality that you're experiencing is built up with lies. And as a result, most of the people get those lies or false information as the absolute truth and build up their lives upon them. Today, the most focused issues in science are the Darwinian evolution theory and the discoveries in the field of cosmology. With the Darwin's theory of evolution, they indoctrinate you to believe that everything is evolving in billions of years from one species to another by natural selection through some random consecutive coincidences. And therefore, human being is also a result of this process.
The priest went on saying that he, the plan of Satan, to deceive the human family this way, he says is the most intriguing thing to his mind. And he went on saying how it was going to be brought about. He said that a fellow by the name of Darwin and another fellow by the name of Thomas Henry Huxley would be used by the spirits, because in their childhood they had been hypnotized by medical doctors, and they figured that they would be real good subjects to lead the people into this belief that they had, that Satan wanted to bring into people's lives. Because after the Great General Council, it was decided that Satan would tutor Charles Darwin personally in setting up the principles of his theories of evolution. He was tutored by Lucifer himself, the fallen Lucifer. And at that time, it was understood, Satan and his spirit counselors understood, that if a person was led to believe in the theory of evolution, it would, in his life, destroyed completely the creation week of the Bible, the fall of man, and the plan of redemption. It would do away with it.
In one fell swoop.
Yeah. Now, he made a unique statement. He said that according to the spirits, anyone that teaches a theory of evolution is considered to be a minister of the great religious system. See, they call it the religious system, the theory of evolution, because it is a system of schooling people and getting them to disqualify themselves and being members of Christ's kingdom. And he said that every teacher of that theory is recognized by the spirits as a person of great value, and receives a very special unctioning from Satan himself, giving great power to induce spiritual blindness, to convince and convert. Three capacities are given to those teachers of the theory. Then, that's not all. The priest says that Satan considers the teachers of the theory of evolution to be so valuable to him that in the sight of all the inhabitants of the galaxies, he assigns a retinue of bright, beautiful angels to follow that educator all the remainder of his life.
And on the other side, there are cosmologists from NASA who claim about some discoveries. For instance, the discovery of planets that resemble Earth, like Kepler-22b or Gliese-581g. With this, they want to convince you that there are other habitable planets in the universe. And then they suggest that the extraterrestrial beings exist and planets like these can be their home. And it's strange that the concept of alien consciousness is one of the most focused issues in science today. It is indeed from the matters of the unseen, and the knowledge is only with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, but there are verses in the Quran that might possibly suggest that there are other creatures in other parts of the universe, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, and He has created things that you do not know. And in another verse He says, and of His signs is the creation of the heavens and earth, and what He has dispersed throughout them of creatures. So according to these and some other verses in the Quran, we do not reject the possibility that there exist other life forms in other parts of this universe. But what these scientists are telling you is fake and is following a big agenda. They want to make you believe that it was always the aliens who were communicating with prophets, and there is no such thing as angels or God.
The project is literally the secularization of the world, to completely strip the world from religious beliefs.
We know the kind of event that it must have been. We know the sort of event that must have happened for the origin of life.
What was that?
It was the origin of the first self-replicating molecule.
Right, and how did that happen?
I told you we don't know.
So you have no idea how it started?
No, nor has anybody.
Nor has anyone else. What do you think is the possibility that intelligent design might turn out to be the answer to some issues in genetics or in evolution?
It could come about in the following way. It could be that at some earlier time, somewhere in the universe, a civilization evolved by probably some kind of Darwinian means to a very, very high level of technology and designed a form of life that they seeded onto perhaps this planet. Now, that is a possibility and an intriguing possibility. Mm. And I suppose it's possible that you might find evidence for that if you look at the details of biochemistry, molecular biology, you might find a signature of some sort of designer.
There's an old joke about, you know, the scientist who is giving the talk about creation, and there's an old lady who stands up in the audience afterwards, you know, and she says, oh, you know, really, you're so ignorant. Don't you know that this entire world is balanced on the back of a giant turtle? And the scientist says, oh, ha, ha, you know, well, tell me, what is the turtle standing on? And the old lady just looks at him and says, you are so stupid. You're so stupid. It's turtles all the way down. Now everybody laughs. What an ignorant old lady. It's turtles all the way down. How silly. Okay, fast forward to modern day. Okay, you have a scientist standing up on stage and he's talking about the Big Bang as the origin of the universe and evolution through natural selection as the explanation for the diversity of life as we know it today. Ask him where the life came from. You know what their answer is now? The most common answer that they're giving now? It came from outer space. Once again, just like what we were talking about, that doesn't answer anything.
Yeah.
They're saying it came from aliens. Where did the aliens come from? Where did the aliens get the quality of life? Oh, they got it from other aliens. And where did they get it from? What is the origin of the aliens? What's the origin of the quality of life? Other aliens, other aliens, other aliens. Now you've got these so-called intelligent scientists looking like this ignorant old lady in the audience. Instead of saying that it's turtles all the way down, they're saying it's aliens all the way up.
Yeah.
You see the first verse of the Bible, book of Genesis, chapter 1, verse 1. It says, in the beginning, God created the heavens and the earth. The word God in Hebrew there is Elohim.
They believe that the word Elohim that has been used for God in Jewish scripture is in fact the name of the extraterrestrial beings which have created mankind with their advanced technology. And therefore the word Elohim have historically been mistaken for gods. They want the whole humanity to accept these aliens as their creators and make the world ready for their arrival on Earth. In fact, they build the third temple for the coming of Dajjal, and their aim is to make people believe that he is one of those extraterrestrial beings. Therefore, when Dajjal comes, those who believe in UFOs and aliens will accept him as their creator.
And there are many, many stories that I heard from people that I trust of their own experience with jinn in the desert and things. So I think that there are people that have had experiences. We tend to ignore a lot of these things that happen to people, like alien abduction. Alien abduction is classic jinn stuff because the jinn do yukhtataf. You know, people get taken by jinn. And they do things to them. And so these type of stories, and you have a lot of people that have had these experiences all over the world.
Now I want to take you to the beginning where Iblis started his enmity with mankind. Do you know why did he refuse to prostrate to Adam alayhi salam? Because he became jealous of him. Although Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given jinn some amazing characteristics that we human beings don't have. Like they have more power, they can appear in different forms, they're invisible to us, they can flow into our bodies, and so many other characteristics that we don't have. But still, there's one thing that Iblis is jealous of, and that's the intellect. Human beings are more intelligent than jinn. And because of his jealousy, he said, I'm better than Adam, peace be upon him, and I don't prostrate to him. So from that moment till now, he uses any opportunity to show that he and his progeny is better than human beings. And today, one of the biggest plans of Iblis is the alien agenda. In fact, there's no such beings that people know as aliens from some science fiction movies or scientific documentaries. The UFOs are advanced military technology. And behind the real abduction cases, there were always jinn, which are not extraterrestrial beings, rather they are extra-dimensional beings who live on Earth. Rael is a 33rd degree Freemason who established the Raelism based on the teachings of Lucifer, and he was always in contact with the jinn who were telling him how to pursue their agendas. So what are the agendas behind the Masonic religion of Raelism? First, they want to make people believe that there is no God. Second, Iblis and his progeny want people to believe that the aliens that are in reality jinn are more intelligent than mankind, even in a level that the followers of this belief accept them as their creators and prostrate to them. Because it is the challenge of Iblis to show that he is better than mankind, and instead of him prostrating to Adam, peace be upon him, human beings should prostrate to him and his progeny. Third, to encourage people practicing evil rituals and to give an extra push to the movements like sex-positive feminism, homosexualism, and etc. And fourth, to make the society ready for the new world order. Do you know why people fall for such big lies? Because they fully trust the education system and the scientists who are being broadcasted on media. And as we mentioned before, the media and education system are mostly focusing on what the system wants from them. The real intelligent scientists don't suggest these sick theories. They rather try to spread the true knowledge about the existence. And day by day, we are witnessing an increasing number of scientists who believe in God. Because real science always indicates the existence of a wise being behind this physical reality.
We are skeptical of claims for the ability of random mutations
and natural selection
to account for the complexity of life.
Careful examination of the evidence
for Darwinian theory
should be encouraged.
Skeptical.
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 Of claims
for the ability of random mutations
and natural selection
to account for
the complexity.
Complexity.
The complexity.
The complexity.
To account for the complexity of life.
And in the short span of about 40 years, in the short span that's what it is, 40 years, you find now an increasing number of scientists believing in a creator. And no longer able to discount a creator, but able to believe in a creator and to believe in what science suggests, such as the Big Bang.
The problem is that the system doesn't promote those scientists who believe in God. They rather promote those who come on the screen and criticize specific religions.
They never criticize Judaism, and as a matter of fact, many of them are strong supporters of Israel. Figure that out. I mean, that's very inconsistent with their beliefs, but that just is the way it is. I mean, most of them they shy away from criticizing Judaism, I think largely because they know that to do so will get them into trouble, and they know which side their bread is buttered on. When they criticize Christianity, they criticize completely on the basis of the tenets of faith, which they cannot they cannot accept. But when it comes to Islam, they don't touch the tenets of faith, because the tenets of faith in Islam are not the issue for them. They always talk about deeply emotional issues, like Islam is just a bunch of terrorists, or they subjugate women. Wait a minute. If Islam subjugates women, why is the greatest number of converts to Islam in first world countries, America, Europe, and so on? Well, why are they predominantly women?
These are
intelligent women becoming Muslim. They're not stupid, ignorant women. These are intelligent women with well-formed opinions and so on, who are becoming Muslim as intelligent women. Why? If Islam subjugates women, why would they do that? Ask them and you'll find the answer. And it's fine, because Islam does not subjugate women. Many of them will tell you that Islam sets them free.
We shouldn't be ignorant about everything that science tells us. We should rather learn things and contemplate and distinguish false from truth. And at the same time, we shouldn't blindly accept whatever is being told to us. Science, in fact, is a method of gaining knowledge through observation of nature. And in multiple verses in the Quran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has commanded us to observe nature and reflect upon His signs in the existence. Significantly, in Islam, religion and science are considered as two complementary sides of one reality, whilst there exists no contradiction between the two, as both emanate from the same source. On the contrary, the Quran encourages people to think, to understand, to question, to criticize, and to find the truth with their intellect. Therefore, we should learn science in the light of faith and find the truth behind the signs that have been set there by the Almighty Creator. He created the whole existence full of signs for the people who reflect upon them.